The base of the crater comprised three separate shafts which yawn beneath their feet. According to the original parchment of Arne Saknussemm, in the last days of the month of June, the shadow of Scartaris would fall upon the opening they were to enter. They knew from the documentation of Professor Lidenbrook that the central shaft was the one that he had taken. But to their astonishment, as the shadow fell, it cast itself over the westerly entrance. Nature had declared for them a different route. Following a gallery of lava which had created a natural descending staircase, their anticipation heightened at the realization that they had now embarked upon an entirely new journey. On reaching the end of the shaft, they entered a narrow tunnel, its calcareous rock walls dating back to the evolution of plant and animal life. Ever descending, they continued through arch after arch, gallery after gallery, their lights constantly reflecting off variegated white and red veined marble, indelibly stamped with impressions of primitive life. As their descent continued, they discovered threads of copper and manganese, whilst displayed within the rock walls, beautiful verdant tints, colored traces of platinum and gold. This, the buried treasure of Mother Earth. For what seemed an eternity, the labyrinth wove a sinuous and winding path, its spiral descent finally reaching an end as the gallery opened up to become a vast mineral forest, majestically illuminated by phosphorescent light. Stalagmites and stalactites served as prisms from which rainbow-colored beams flew in every direction, simultaneously lighting a pathway through this newly discovered subterranean mineralogical kingdom. It led to an almost perfectly formed descending terrestrial staircase. After successfully negotiating the avenue of prismed light, they reached the staircase. Carefully, they began the slow descent into the ever-darkening chasm. As tiredness took hold, the weary travelers found shelter within a recess that nature had carved out of the rock wall as if awaiting their arrival. As they lay exhausted, the ground beneath them began to tremble. Slight at first, the tremors soon increased to terrifying proportions. Huge cracks appeared all around them and fear replaced bewilderment. The earth cried out in pain as if its subterranean world was about to split into a thousand fragments. The earthquake had begun.